Cummings, the man in charge of this match. British referee. And now the traditional haka. There from the Kiwis, the men in black and white, Nathan Cayless on screen there, young Parramatta forward and captain, coming off the bench today. A lot depends on how Stuart Cummings will rule on this one. Some controversy about Mr. Cummings being selected ahead of Russell Smith. Standby for kickoff, and we're privileged to bring you the action on the wide world of sports from Old Trafford. Thunderous reception from the crowd here, and Craig Smith is the man who brings it back first. The pitch is coming courtesy of the good people at Sky Sports. They've been with us all along through this tournament. It's had its highs, it's had its lows. And the Kiwis, both teams of course unbeaten through five matches to reach this point. The Australians surviving a scare last Sunday in Huddersfield against the Welsh. First set of six for the Kiwis. And Henry Paul kicking from just outside his 20-metre line. Saylor won't contest it. One bounce and over the sideline. You'd describe that as a steady start from the Kiwis. Kicking before the last.
Such a talented player is Henry Paul, a key man for the Kiwis, as is his brother Robbie Paul coming off the bench for this game. We did not see him used to great effect last week against England. Didn't get much game time. I don't think that will be the case this afternoon. Wendell Saylor into 5-8 from this scrum win.
And Wendell, who's bagged 8 tries in this tournament, alongside Lesley Vainikolo, who he marks today. It's a defeating, a real showdown. The two leading try scorers for the tournament. Wendell's boot came flying out of that previous tackle. It's up in the bleachers. And the Kangaroos 45 metres away, and Webke gets his first touch on the football. And a strong card as always from the Broncos front rower. John's a dummy half. And for Kearns, cleanly shaven for this match. 30 metres away from the Kiwis line. They scored after 5 minutes, if my memory serves me correctly, in the Anzac test. It was Brad Fittler who sliced through. Kamali kicking for the wing of Vainikolo. Sailors coming through. They haven't got it, the Kiwis. It's over the sideline. Little bit of concern there for Barnett and for Vainikolo.
Here and in the warm-up before the game, Brad Fittler and Brett Kamali were putting up a lot of bombs. We probably only have about a 4.5 to 5 metre in goal here at Old Trafford. And the bomb looks like it will be the tactics for the Australian today, but a tremendous opportunity. Scrum 10 metres out.
Real pressure early on the Kiwis.
I've got 2 inches more space there.
It's going to be a delay with this scrum packing. Kamali and Jones, the two number sevens. Kamali off to the Northern Eagles next year. Scored his first try for the tournament last week against Wales. There's really only a sprinkling of players across both squads that have failed to make the scorer sheet at this tournament. Here is Fittler. And working Lockyer into the action. And now Rogers. The New Zealand fans, they're still having nightmares about Rogers from the Anzac test. MacDougall in the starting side at centre, replacing Girdler. They are 5 away. Fittler is drifting to the blind side, and it's Webke who crashes up to within 4 of the line. Smith there in defence. And with Johns. And Kamali, cutout ball, flat-footed as Hill. Taking on Kearney. Kearney's able to shut him down. But still 5 metres away. Talas trying to bulldog his way to that try line. He's left one behind. It was Richard Swain. Fifth tackle for the Kangaroos. And it's back with Kamali. The grubber kick to this short in goal. It's been handled pretty well in the finish for the Kiwis. I think it was Wiki, wasn't it, who got back there.
I think it's Henry Paul who gets down. Facing back to his own gold line. And was able to defuse the situation. That's a positive start for New Zealand, the fact they were able to keep their defence intact. Tonie Carroll, a good charge away from his own line, almost to the 20.
For Tonie Carroll, the first time he comes up against his former Bronco teammates. And no coincidence, Talas was first man in there to make the tackle. Strong hit up from Vagana. Frank Endacott watches on. And coach since 93. And now the alternate kicker, it's Stacey Jones from inside the 40. Wendell, almost a nutmeg here. Vainikolo, Talau up there to make the tackle. So they start this set of 6:15 inside their own half.
I know there's no great place to kick the football, but I'm surprised that the first two kicks from New Zealand have gone towards Wendell Saylor's wing. He'd be the last person I'd be kicking to in broken play.
Andrew Johns, and for Webke again, third charge for the match. Running headlong into Pongia, who's really returned to football with a bang at this tournament. He's been up with the best in the Kiwi forward pack, only played three first grade matches this year. MacDougall, so you've got the two blonde-haired players on the left side of the park, MacDougall and Rogers. Fifth tackle, Kamali's bomb. Barnett will have time. In front of his own posts, he's made a mess of it, Richie Barnett. It will be a line dropout. And what a tester for the New Zealand captain early.
Yeah, real floater from Brett Kamali. And I think that Richie Barnett was balked a little bit by his goalposts. He lost contact with exactly where on the field he was. As a result, mistimed his leap. Another great opportunity from a line dropout for the Australians. The bomb looks like the order of the day, Stirlo, for the fifth tackle.
I think that'll be the last time we see it. A bit of a problem there for Adam MacDougall. He was hurt in this tackle by Tonie Carroll. Well, he might have twisted an ankle. Trainer still with him, and that's a tremendous dropout. Darren Lockyer, well, it's been ruled knocked back, but that was 60 metres on the fly as he takes it to Stacey Jones.
Let's watch it again, Lockyer. Ooh, gee. Close call.
You should point out to those people who don't watch rugby league that often, despite the fact you're not facing forward, if you propel the ball forwards, and that looked as though to me it may have done, it is still a knock-on.
They find themselves in good position again, the Kangaroos. Still no score, though. Kamali working that right side with Fletcher. He's been on a bit of a try-scoring rush lately over here. Highlighted by a hat-trick in the quarterfinals. Talas works the right side. And plenty of troops coming on Big Gordon. Over the top was Talau. Wiki was low. Everything we expected so far. Kamali's kick across field. This time it's Vagana who's got pressure. Flying through was Lockyer. With that small in goal, Lockyer almost had to jump the high jump at the finish. Very close to the advertising hoardings here at Old Trafford. Little margin for error. And the Kiwis come back with the ball. And seven gone was Swain. Away. I will amend what I predicted may have been the crowd figure. I'm pretty sure it's 40 or 45,000.
Adam MacDougall is still being troubled by that ankle injury. That's seen him push Matt Rogers into the centres. But the Newcastle three-quarter still looks very ginger out here on the left wing as New Zealand struggle to bring out of their own end.
They're having trouble making any impression here, the Kiwis. Wiki, a bit of a wrestle there with Hill. Paul gets them to the left with Kearney. Again, an argument is raged as to the second row supremacy in World League, if you like. Talas and Kearney. Kearney's probably shaded Talas here. And here is Wendell again on the end of a kick. Links up with Lockyer. Rogers is floating. He's with it. Line of Kiwi defenders, then back for Saylor. Some nice work at the back, but the defence stood their ground. MacDougall is down again for the Aussies, short of halfway. As Rogers goes for another scamper. At the time, it was a point-scoring record in that Anzac test for Matt Rogers on the night as the Australians get a penalty. He scored 58 points in this tournament, Matt Rogers. On that night, he bagged 24, 8 goals and 2 tries. MacDougall on screen. Right ankle, the problem. And obviously, that will play on his mind as well. Webke again. They're set to the left, they're 35 metres out, and as with Cairns, Melbourne captain.
And a couple of the strike players for Australia, getting themselves set to the left. Fittler going to Talas, finds Lockyer. But again, the communication between Vagana and Tony Carroll is good.
Lodges back with Fittler. Quick to feed along for Kamali. They keep going now with Fletcher, who's able to keep it alive. And now the turnover with Kearney. It promised. It was close. And they turned it over. The build-up was fine. The Australians hand out some punishment of their own. Solo on Vainikolo. Matchups right across the park here. Kiwis in possession, outside their 30. This is Smith. 15 inside his own half. Swain. Hey, the ball was slow. Maybe some of the Australian defenders to get up. That is a wonderful tackle from MacDougall. Front on.
It needed to be. They had a three-man overlap as Cummins finds a penalty against Adam MacDougall, a hand in the play the ball area to slow things down. But a real chance there for the Kiwis if they could have got a catch and pass from Richie Barnett.
Reception for that penalty. Definitely the crowd at the backs of New Zealand. Here is Pongia, their best chance to date. 25 metres out from the Kangaroos' line. And Swain. Jones and head on for Wiki. I can't honestly recall Ruben Wiki playing lock forward for Canberra this year. He covered prop in second row, but I can't remember him at lock, but he's been there in this tournament. Wonderful defence from the Australians. Brad Fittler driving it on Matt Ruar. Back it comes for Smith. He's 12 away. He's lost it in the tackle. Play on, says Cummings. Jones holds it up for Carroll. And again, Carroll is picked up by Talas but keeps it alive. Smith is with it. And the crowd really comes alive as well. 12 away. And again, it's no play the ball. Swain. With Jones. The kick is threaded through. He was knocked down. Saylor has batted it dead. In fact, Cummings has ruled it was over that dead ball line.
Ooh, Jim, keen to have a look at this on replay again. Oh, well, that's the old chestnut rule, isn't it? Putting the foot over the dead ball line will not be the case in the NRL next year, and that is a good thing.
Just interesting to watch New Zealand during that set of six. They were prepared to force a couple of offloads there. I guess they feel as though they can't get through an organised Australian defence. Perhaps a little bit of offloading and second phase play may give them the jink that they're looking for. Different attitude to what they've played the rest of the tournament.
Talas really mixing it with the New Zealand forwards here. Kamali, another kick. He was under pressure there from Kearney. And hence the kick, probably not as the quality that Kamali would have been pursuing. The chase is good though. And MacDougall and Rogers do the job on Vagana. And some of the Kiwis slow to get back as Barnett has to go for a rush back to that 30-metre line. Started the tournament in wonderful style. His first game since that Anzac test. Scored a couple of tries against Lebanon at Gloucester and then proceeded to score two tries in each of the next two games. So six tries in three games on return for Richie Barnett. He's been one of the players of the tournament. And they kick with Henry Paul. Again, it's to Wendell Saylor's side of the field. We'll find Lockyer though. Some of the Australian players starting to warm up on the bench. The interchange here, and a veteran in Darren Britt alongside them. Webke's gone to the bench, and Jason Stevens, the first man out there. 40 away from their own line. Fletcher from the Roosters. Big year for him. State of Origin success, grand final appearance, and now World Cup campaign. Stevens gets his first touch. He's provoked some, I guess you could describe it, hatred from the English fans very early. The first match at Twickenham. He wasn't afraid to mix it. Kamali, 45 metres out, kicking high again. This is going to go down the throat of Vainikolo. I think back to that Anzac test, he had some problems with a high ball that night.
I think he's lost the football there as well. The Australian players appealing that was the case. No joy from the referee as Nigel Vagana gets involved from the right wing.
Watching MacDougall, he's in big trouble again now. He's looking, well, you'd say he's pulled up lame, to be honest, out of MacDougall. He's in big strife. He's looked round to the bench as the Kiwis take the quick tap. Back to the 40-metre line. Some cries that Kearns was offside.
Well, it was a mile offside. Never retreated at all. Should have been another penalty as Joe Vagana gets involved. I can't believe that the referee didn't issue another penalty on that occasion.
Cayless is 39 away. Paul barking instructions to his Kiwi teammates. Jones works the right side. And inside, Talas came up with a shoulder on Wiki. Missed. There was no great net gain for New Zealand, but not a practice you want to see from Gordon when you're defending 30 metres out from your own line. Here is Paul. Lurching forward was Kearney to take it. Risky pass, batted back by Fittler. It's play on for the Australians. Stevens comes up with it and gives us a chance to go down to Chris Bombalis on the sideline.
Yes, fellas, I've been keeping an eye on Adam MacDougall. He's again with one of the trainers. He is struggling with that ankle. I'm sure the trainers want to get him off, but he is insistent, the Newcastle centre, that he wants to stay out there, try and run that pain out of the ankle.
Well, against Wales in the semi-final, there's a chance here for the Australians through that man MacDougall. Steps back inside. Good cover from Ruler. Lockyer is there.
Support from the number one, and MacDougall did well. Clearly hampered. 30 away, Fittler. Kamali. Let's get it going to the right, they say. Johns and Gidley. The Newcastle boys are there. Now Saylor, weaving his way to the line and tackled 5 metres short. Big opportunity then. Saylor was a little slow to his feet. Kamali, it's the fifth tackle. They'll kick across to the wing of Matt Rogers. It's question time on Vagana, and he answers in the best way.
Yeah, good take there from Vagana. This is an obvious tactic from the Australians, kicking at the wingers. Just saying earlier that in the Welsh semi-final, Australia had problems with Ryan Girdler. He was hurt after 20 minutes. Trent Barrett came into the game and slotted into the centre position. We may not be too far away from that happening in this match.
And the Kiwis pushing the pass inside their 20. Little Stacey Jones and Kamali meet head-to-head. And Kamali has pinched it. Chance then with Fletcher. 20 away from the line. Wiki makes the tackle. He was building up for New Zealand quickly. It turned in the same moment.
They're just on their heels a little bit here, the Kiwis. A lot of tackling is taking its toll.
Kamali. Laid out. Inside pass for Talas. They only just have Gordon. It was only an ankle clutch that prevented him scoring. Kamali wide with Hill, then Gidley. Keeps it alive for Saylor. He's put it down.
Well, that is a great sign for New Zealand, because I agree with Phil Gould. New Zealand were in trouble. A lot of defence. Wendell Saylor putting the football down there. In the past, in April, Australia would have scored in that situation. That is the difference normally between these two sides. Under pressure like that, you will see Australia score. This time they have not been able to. It is a good sign for the Kiwis.
We saw from that replay just for a moment, Vainikolo was caught in two minds, was almost coming in to complete the tackle on Gidley. That would have left Saylor unmarked. Last week, Gidley set up, just a cracker of a try for Saylor. Pass around the corner against the Welsh. New Zealand come out of trouble. Barnett. Talas getting through plenty of defence. It's all rugged stuff from Talas.
I've got no doubt that Barnett and Vainikolo have got to come in and do a little bit of the forwards work in their own half. Where they spread the ball previously, there is a sign of tiredness. These backs have got to come in and help run the ball, relieve a little bit of pressure.
Henry Paul added some spark, and now Swain steals another 6 or 7 metres. Fifth tackle. But they have made their way inside Kangaroo territory. What a tough slog the last few minutes. Paul, a high kick. He's found space between Saylor and Lockyer. Chase is good from New Zealand. Saylor, though, will take them on. But Rua is there first with young Cayless. And this time it's the Australians that start the set of six inside their 20. Rogers in close to the action. Jones the tackle. Rogers missing last week's semi-final against Wales. Andrew Johns. And again, MacDougall has gone down. In back play, Rogers another run inside New Zealand's half. Got away from Carroll. Carroll's defence brutal at times last week in the semi against England. Kamali, fifth tackle. He'll kick again across to Vainikolo. It's an air raid again from the Kangaroos, and Vainikolo takes it high up on the chest. They've turned it over again. Barnett back on his own goal line. Cummings waving his arms like a windmill, says play on. Away for the Kiwis. And left behind that time was Kearns. from New Zealand back to their 30.
With the bomb barrage that we're getting, you've got the New Zealand wingers knowing for five tackles that it's eventually going to come. You can see there the signs of nervousness all the time. The Australians playing it well.
Some scrappy play there from the Kiwis, but Kearney is back with it, and that is, well, the tackle has forced the error on Kearney. It was Hill and Kamali in there. It looked a little ungamely at first viewing, but in the end it's proved very effective. Touch of Des Hasler about it, jumping up in the tackle there from Kamali.
Yeah, he certainly put it down there. Peter, I just get the feeling that around the rucks, New Zealand are ready to crack. It looks as though their forwards are starting to get flat-footed, and John's Lockyer lurking behind the play the ball. Look as though they're warming up to something.
Well, if that's the case, and I do agree, we are about to find out whether this is the best New Zealand side to have represented and whether they do have claims to this world title. Now is the question time for New Zealand, and it will be answered in the next 5 to 10 minutes.
As Darren Britt prepares to come into the match, Andrew Johns passes wide with Hill. He's only got Saylor on his outside. He sends Wendell on a chase through. Vainikolo! I'm not sure what the communication was there between Jones and Vainikolo, but I don't think Lesley wanted a bar of it there for a moment. He was forced to play at it. And Saylor gave him a good little push in the back for his troubles. What a battle's developing on that wing. The Volcano against Wendell. Mount Ruapehu against Mount Vesuvius or something along those lines. Ruapehu's in New Zealand, Gus.
Thank you for that.
And back comes Darren Britt. I think Vesuvius claimed Pompeii. I don't think it's got much to do with Wendell. Wasn't his fault. Here's Jason Stevens. 25 away from the line. Certainly in the territory stakes, the Australians have had the better of it. Fittler runs up to the line.
Some freshmen out there for Australia. Nathan Hindmarsh wide to the right. Talas goes to the left.
Talas all on his own. He's five out. And out there. Little Stacey Jones, no surprise. The big Gordon now. MacDougall tries to wriggle his way over the line. It's the fifth tackle. He's still out there. He's playing at about, I'd reckon, 60% fitness at the moment, Adam MacDougall. Kamali's kick. Ricochet off the legs of Cayless. Scooped up there by Fittler. Still alive for the Kangaroos. Battle for the loose ball. Cummings has ruled six to go. Well, I'm not happy with that. What an opportunity. Surely they'll crack this time, but maybe it'll be the Kangaroos. Vainikolo's dropped it onto the intercept. Big Darren Britt comes up with a ball. Still on for the Aussies. Hindmarsh, five from that line.
Chance to the left here if Australia can move the ball quickly. Fittler is there.
Full set of six to work with. Kamali, he had Lockyer on his outside. He passes for MacDougall. Wonderful defence from New Zealand. Cracking stuff. Vagana off his line. Under pressure, made a decision. And here is Stevens. He's 10 out. Maybe a little, just a fraction fragile, but it's to be commended thus far their efforts in defence, the Kiwis. Hindmarsh, he's only five away. This cup final is alive and well. Johns passing for Hill, spinning close to the line. Now Saylor on the bounce. Props, gets round Vainikolo. Saylor all strength, scores the first try. Over in the corner.
Well, it's a good contest with Vainikolo over there, but he is a mile in front. Lesley dropped the football to give Australia possession once again. And Wendell Saylor, that's the end of it. At the beginning of it, he was faced by three black and white jerseys. He was good enough. Now, has he got the ball down, or has Stephen Kearney got his hand underneath the football to deny the ball being placed? I think the point of the football touches the ground. For mine, that shows a four-pointer. Wonderful effort from Kearney, poor effort from Vainikolo.
It's tight, but, oh, gee. I think first, the moment he gets in goal, Gus, I'm of the belief that he has forced it. What happened after that is of no consequence if he has got it down here.
It's fairly graphic, isn't it? You've got to assume that the point of the football there is brushed the grass. And even momentarily following that, Kearney's hand does lift the ball again. It's only an instant that the ball touches the ground. Yeah, I think the right hand of Saylor is able to get enough pressure to roll the point of the football across the forearm of Kearney underneath.
Well, just have a look at the red part of the football. I'm sure that that shows that the ball does actually touch the ground. I've got no doubt. Well,
what about that? Wendell cannot believe it. Jerry Kershaw is the video referee here. And he has made a very popular decision, it must be said, at Old Trafford. They're saying Kershaw for mayor.
You can tell from my comments that I am completely flabbergasted by that one. For mine, I'm sure the point of the football, the red marking on the football, touched the ground despite the attention of Stephen Kearney's hand.
Yeah, well, the New Zealanders have got to back this up. They've dodged a bullet. They all ran over and patted Kearney on the head. They've got to back it up with a big set of six defence here to capitalise on that bit of good fortune. Well, interesting to see how the Australians react to this situation. They believe they scored a fair try.
So held up in goal, they get the feed, and Fittler takes them straight on, and they're fired up now. They think they've been denied a fair try. Lockyer, and now the free running of young Hindmarsh. Only 3 metres away, Wiki. In defence, very physical again.
I'd be looking to put Wendell straight at Vainikolo as soon as possible once again.
Darren Brett right in front of the New Zealand posts. Kearney's there again. I should mention too, Kearney today becomes the most capped forward in New Zealand Test history. Andrew Johns passes for Kamali, then back for Tallis. They're reading the inside ball well. It was Swain low in the tackle. Johns, Kamali. Fittler's there on his outside. They cut out Lockyer. It's on the bounce to Rogers. Back in seal, infield. 15 away from the line. And Wiki over the top. The low man was Joe Vagana. Fifth tackle. No score. World Cup final. Kamali. He shaped a kick low. Back inside. Went wide and high. It's fielded by Kearney. Well, he is. Well, he's the magician at the moment, Stephen Kearney.
Yeah, good work by the Kiwis. Now they've got to try and work the ball off their line to back up the good defence. It's just minute by minute. Each minute's got to complement the last. The Australians actually look to struggle a little bit when they're close to the opposition try line. They are flat, Sturlo, aren't they? It's fair enough in general play, but close to the line, it's giving the Kiwis a chance to get up and bustle them.
Look at Carroll go. Back to the 40-metre line.
But for Australia, that's not going to change because it's the pattern we've seen them play for a long time now with Brett Kamali at halfback. He plays exactly the same way for the Melbourne Storm, or did so under Chris Anderson. I'm wondering whether Australia can adapt to a deeper game as Wendell Saylor again beats one, tries to beat two. Three players bring him to ground, 25 out from his own line.
And if Wendell needed any stirring up, it has happened. And good standing in this tackle. They can't get him to ground, now they do. Vagana and Wiki. His tackle count mounting, did some big defence on his own goal line.
Big rap also for Richard Swain around the ruck area. The Australians bring a lot of this kind of running at them, at him in the shape of Talas. Unfortunately, he's missed that one, but he's been very good the last 10 minutes. Tremendous run from Gordon Talas.
35 away from the line. Swain averaged 35 tackles this year, a game with Melbourne. Kamali and Vagana came up swinging out of the attempted tackle. Johns, I don't think the Kiwis were back 10 then. Hill, batted on by Gidley. Saylor tries a kick. He'll try it all on his own this time. Gidley has gone very close. In fact, it might be right on the money. Matthew Gidley, the Australians celebrate. They will wait for the green light, though. The try decision, again, it will be over to Jerry Kershaw. That's a try. For the Kangaroos.
That one will not be denied. And New Zealand, well, they've done all the hard work, got through to the last tackle, and somehow did not cover that up, and it was only through looking for somebody else to be the person to do so. Stephen Kearney again led the charge, but whether it's really his job to be doing that, be keen to find out who else should have been able to chase.
You just see that replay, is he onside? It's a difficult angle. There's half a step in it. Certainly something we weren't contemplating originally.
I've got no problem with that. I'm sure he's onside there.
Smart work from Wendell. And again, the player there, last man, was Kearney.
And again, you know, Richie Barnett's there as well. Okay, maybe he thought Kearney had it, but just his presence, Richie Barnett, in going for the football, it may have helped.
And that is a try. We're on the board in the World Cup. Cup final. It's 4-0 to the Kangaroos.
Yeah, of course, last week we spoke about Richie Barnett and his nervousness to the rolling ball following that horrific injury early in the year. He admitted that he still wasn't 100% confident about getting his head down in those situations. Maybe that was on his mind. But let me tell you something about this Australian performance. I went to training on Thursday, and they virtually directed all of their play down their left-hand side of the field towards MacDougall and towards Rogers. Now, they know that MacDougall's injured. It takes a top-class group of footballers to change your game, and now virtually everything's gone to the right towards Wendell. And once they've had a few opportunities, they've kept the play going that way and now come up with the ultimate reward.
He looks like the warrior now, Matt Rogers. 58 points for the tournament. First conversion attempt of the day in flight from Matt Rogers. It is beautiful. It is 6-0. We will break from Old Trafford. 6-0 to the Kangaroos. We welcome you back to Manchester. Early hours of the morning back home. 25-4 local time here on a Saturday afternoon. Yeah. Well, I guess the best-known team in world soccer, Manchester United, have given way for Rugby League to take centre stage here today. Cummings hasn't detected a knock-on there for the Australians. The first try for Gidley, but here it was there, perhaps off the leg of Andrew Johns. That's the way Cummings saw it. Let's not forget the work of Saylor. That was real skill. His kick around the outside of Vainikolo to set it up for Gidley. Kamali's kick. Barnett will return from the 10-metre line. Fittler first man there, captain on captain.
Yeah, he is playing very deep, Richie Barnett, too. I wouldn't mind betting it sooner or later. Lockyer or even Kamali put a little grubber kick behind the line, make him come forward to the football and see if he wants to go down on it. That's the test that he'll be waiting for. A penalty now for New Zealand, which will relieve the pressure for them. They need a couple of good sets of six back-to-back here just to get themselves back in the game confidence-wise.
It was fine work from Nigel Vagana. He's having a good game. Saw that that Lockyer was slow in going back, ran at him, earned his side a penalty. And they haven't seen too much of this end of the field through the course of this match as they go to the back line. Henry Paul, ooh!
They're away. It's their turn now with Talau. Keeping it alive for Vainikolo, who loses it. Gee, there was some near things in that build-up from New Zealand.
Yeah, as Peter Sterling said earlier in the game, class players in clutch situations. Willie Talau had a perfect opportunity to put Vainikolo back on the inside, but turned his back the wrong way. The pass was a poor one. The big man needed it right on his chest so he could keep up his head of steam. You see, Talau should have turned the ball towards Vainikolo so he could have seen it the whole time. Lost contact with it, and an opportunity gone begging for big Lesley Vainikolo.
So it settles again, and back with Stevens.
For an instant there, I saw intercept Wendell Saylor.
Andrew Johns testing that groin out. 20-metre dart. Number 9 on his back.
That's where New Zealand are getting tired up the middle. Here's Hill out of dummy half again.
30 away from the line. They drive in hard, Carroll, but they keep it alive with MacDougall. And then back, Hindmarsh. He's only 22 away. Jones over the top.
Chris Anderson rated Hindmarsh the most improved player on tour.
Kamali kicks. Following Vainikolo again. Saylor comes through. Vainikolo comes down with it. And the Kiwis return. Oh, I'll say it again. What a battle it is between Vainikolo and Saylor.
Attaboy Lesley. He's finally come up with one for himself there. That'll do his confidence no end of good.
Talking about a 21-year-old, he's got a fair deal of first-grade experience, but this is the biggest occasion of his career right here, right now, in Old Trafford. It is the real acid test.
I might be right in saying that early in the season, in that Anzac test, he was called upon by New Zealand while playing reserve grade for Canberra. He certainly didn't start the year off well, looking to finish it on the highest possible note.
45 away from the line. New Zealand happy just to have the ball back and away from their own danger zone. A high kick. I won't call it bad until we see the end result. It bounced up for Rogers. It's play on here. MacDougall goes back. He's got Vagana wrong-footed. He's done the same to Swann. And he's managed to get it back over the 20. That was the bounce. A tough one. So MacDougall has done very well. It was the first 5 minutes when he injured that ankle. And he's still there. Robbie Kearns now, we're told, has a problem for the Kangaroos. Fletcher. Lovely flick out the back for Johns. With a dummy, but Vagana is there again. Jones in his customary position out wide in defence. Hill inside the New Zealand half. Jones called into the action again. Craig Smith, the man who added his weight over the top on the Australian lock forward. Here is Fittler. This is Kamali. Then on for Fletcher. Stops that left arm out. Trying to fend off Henry Paul. Untidy play, the ball from Fletcher. He puts forward his case. It's been dismissed by Judge Cummings.
Yeah, I guess all's fair in love and war. Both teams really testing each other in that play the ball area. Looking for a result. New Zealand got a good one there. Probably should have been a penalty. Brian Fletcher known to carry the ball loose. Always looking for a quick play of the ball or an offload. The Kiwis, again, this last 7 or 8 minutes before half-time, got to get themselves and put a couple of shots on this Australian team.
The Kiwis will counter. They've threatened a number of times. It's just building on those half-breaks they're making.
I've got to say that Andrew Johns back at hooker has really made the Australian defence line strong around the middle. He's come up with a lot of tackling in there.
Pongia was able to push a ball back, and Henry Paul had to wait for someone to get onside. Eventually, it's Swann who got there. Touch of Rugby Union Sevens about the play, though. Carroll, MacDougall takes Carroll close to the sideline. Two big, strong centres there. Jones, floating pass. Paul's kick. Barnett is onside, chasing through. Saylor gets to it, though. Quick to link up with Lockyer. The Brisbane connection at the back. And Lockyer back over the 20.
Yeah, it's strange for New Zealand. You know, all tournament, they've worked the play to the middle of the field, set up with options both sides, and then prepared to have their shot. Today, they seem to be working the play to one side of the field, looking for a spread of the ball. Number one, it's not suited to the conditions. And number two, they've gone all tournament with a successful pattern. They've changed it for the big day, and they seem to be struggling in offence.
This is short of the 40. And Jason Stevens. Real Bullock-like effort from Jason Stevens as he's come off the bench. It's been pretty simple but effective. And Kamali, another run for him. 45 away from the New Zealand line, and that is the fifth tackle. Andrew Johnson, dummy half. Lockie's in position to provide the kick here. He's got it. Darren Lockyer, and that is the left foot of Lockyer, one of the sweetest kickers in the game. It's down that man again, Vainikolo. He's lost it. I don't think it was a mid-air tackle. Vainikolo had both his feet on the ground. Yep, definitely shown up by the replay. Spot on the people from Sky Sports. And the Australians are back with it. 25 away from the line. Coming up to half-time, 5.5 remaining.
And I believe that Australia can go a long way to wrapping up this World Cup in the next 6 minutes. If they can score here, well, they're not going to. Here's Stacey Jones.
Little Jones away. Over the 30 and then over the 40 and cut down from behind by MacDougall. Kiwi's chance. It swings back their way. Smith wants a charge. And that he does to within 45 of the Australian line. Crowd lifts again, getting behind the underdog. Barnett right on that Australian 40-metre line. The Aussies have regrouped. The defence is holding firm again. Paul, they go wide with Kearney. Wholehearted performance from Stephen Kearney in the first half. Mountain of test football behind him. Pongia is 25 away. And Paul, and now Jones, second receiver, then wide. It comes for Carroll. He got away from MacDougall. Flung the ground there by Rogers. They're 10 away. It's a fifth tackle. The Kiwis with Jones. Some indecision there. And Jones kick across the face of goal. Comes down for Saylor. And who's on his back? It's Vainikolo.
His eyes lit up there, Lesley Vainikolo. He said, here's one where I can get a shot. Didn't quite collect him the way he wanted. But a bit of pressure back on Big Wendell. Just might make him think twice.
This is a chance to go to the sideline, Chris Bombalis.
Yeah, great action here on the sideline. We saw bravely before Adam MacDougall chase down the in cover. He's got a sprained ankle. He's got that strapped. He's struggling with that, but he's going to continue on. Robbie Kearns is the other guy with a bit of concern on the bench. He had an infected elbow. He's got that strapped and took a couple of heavy knocks on it.
Fittler kicks off the side of the boot, just a touch.
And as Richie Barnett cleans up that kick, Stephen Kearney is also very dusty at the moment. And that would be a huge body blow if he does not complete this match. He's been their best, but took a knock in a tackle only moments ago and is still not recovered.
Just looking at the two teams, when it gets a little bit tough and both teams are running on a bit of fatigue, you can see the Australian players physically force themselves to hold their line or to chase their kicks, where the New Zealanders tend to give in a little bit to the fatigue. And as the game wears on, that's the most telling factor in the two defences. The New Zealanders don't quite push themselves hard enough into position. The Australians very, very honest with their work.
All the same, it's a different ball game to what we had on April 21. 22-0 it was at half-time.
Oh, they're in the game, the Kiwis. Don't worry about that.
40 away from the line. And Swain finds himself having to kick here on the last. It's high. It's got Lockyer going back towards his upright. And that is always a worry. Now Lockyer is trapped like a rabbit against a lion. He is devoured by the defence coming through. It was Swann.
And as we saw with Richie Barnett early in the game, the goal post was the problem for Darren Lockyer. The ball swirling around, running back towards his post. And that was set up by this Stacey Jones break. Australia on the attack. I was about to say if they score there, they could just about wrap things up. But immediately, a mistake from the Aussies and a slow restart from underneath their posts.
Well, I hope this atmosphere is being conveyed to you back home. Sitting here live, watching on this match and the crowd lifting behind New Zealand there. It is a wonderful venue for sport.
Gee, that's poor from New Zealand there. Nobody getting through and catching that on the full. They gave the Australian chasers an extra 10 yards.
Craig Smith. Sideways on the tackle. One of two St George Illawarra players involved in this World Cup final. Trent Barrett the other. We'll see him later. 25 away from the line. Chance for the Kiwis. Jones. Swann was there in support. It comes up for Carroll. Then for Vagana. Carroll didn't make it easy for Nigel. He was close to the sideline. Taken by MacDougall. Now Logan Swann. He's 11 away from the line. Fifth tackle for the Kiwis. Big play here coming up to half-time. Paul's kick. Lockyer does beautifully at the back for the Kangaroos. Didn't take any risks. Made sure he covered up. And what's more, made sure he remained in the field of play. Now the hammer defence on Saylor. But this was the work of Lockyer. Clive Churchill medal winner this year. Just a little reminder of his skills. And his poise at the back. And still only 23 years of age. Darren Britt, the oldest man out there for the Australians, short of the 20, Stevens. Of the four front rowers that are rotated in the Australian side, I don't think anyone's done any more hit-ups than Jason Stevens. Vainikolo will get one more run before half-time. See if he can get it to top gear quickly. Hill there with Gidley, lone try scorer in this match, the Newcastle centre. Could loom up at 5'8 next year with Matt Johns off to Wigan. And that's down the track. Talau five short of halfway. And they come left with Wiki.
New Zealand would love to get close enough to put up a kick at the end of this tackle count. May not get that close now with the four or the third tackle on halfway.
If the Australians were playing Wales, they'd probably go for the field goal. The Welsh, Carroll's kick ricocheted off the legs of Rogers. I don't think the tackle count will restart here. Now it will. Rogers got a hand to it. Swann, got away for Vagana. Vagana decides to kick. It was before the first tackle, but time is up. So, an enthralling and absorbing first 40 minutes of the World Cup final. The number one and the number two seeds facing off here at Old Trafford in Manchester. And just the one score in the first half. A try to Matt Gidley off a Wendell Saylor grubber. And Matt Rogers, superb, a conversion from the sideline. So we will break from Old Trafford. Hope you're enjoying the coverage on the wide world of sports. Australia 6, leading New Zealand 0.
Just some of the action from another quality NRL domestic season, which has led us through to International Rugby League. We are at Old Trafford and we are here for the World Cup decider. And it must be said, a fitting first 40 minutes here with only the one try scored. Australia lead 6-0 at the break. but they've done it tough getting there. Just the one try to Matthew Gidley that came after about 25 minutes. It was converted from the touchline by Matt Rogers. New Zealand, not too many opportunities, but they have looked very, very good opposition in the first half here. Phil Gould, we predicted it would be a close final. People were saying that this is New Zealand's best ever chance. How have you seen it?
Well, I really think the Australians have been more creative, more confident, and the New Zealanders are just hanging on for mine. They really haven't had good field position to get the Australian tackle counts up, and a couple of lost opportunities, the scoreboard could be a little bit more. But it's only 6-0. Coach Frank Endacott will be saying nothing has really changed from our first ambition. We're still in the football game. A little bit go our way, we can take home the World Cup.
Well, without doubt, the most controversial incident in the first half was a no-try called against Wendell Saylor. I must admit, I disagreed with the video referee. This is what we saw.
This cup final is alive and well. John at Old Trafford. Wendell Saylor denied a try in that first half. Having watched the replays that Phil and Peter talk you through at half-time, I'm more convinced than ever that it was a four-pointer for Wendell Saylor. Anyway, he's got a remarkable strike rate at the moment. He's scored 8 tries at this tournament, 11 tries in his last 5 tests. So I'm thinking that Wendell won't find his way to the line at some stage in these next 40 minutes. And of course, with the score so close, we may be looking at the possibility of extra time, as it wasn't that semi-final back in 95 between these two teams. Level at full-time, it's 10 minutes extra each way. And then the golden point is applied, and we've got a gentleman that's forgot to get dressed who's made his way out onto Old Trafford, and he's pretty keen to meet Stuart Cummings.
Well, I don't understand streaking at the best of time. When it's 0 degrees, I am fully flummoxed.
Well, he's got a back hairier than Fatty. And
hang on.
That's a big statement. I appreciate that. Henry Paul not all that amused with the way things are going. And we now have almost like a fireworks display, the number of flashes going off here. Flasher being the operative word, I suppose, there. And he's conceded, our streaker friend. They tell me his name's Mario. It's a coincidence, I guess. But there you have it.
He showed a bit of speed, but he had no tread for his footwork. He kept slipping in the conditions.
I was just thinking, when I saw the camera flashes going off, there'll be those one-hour Photoshops tomorrow saying we're getting all these photos of this bloke with no gear on. We start the second half anyway. Some levity as we get down to the serious business. A World Cup up for grabs, the 12th in history. The Aussies already have 8. Great Britain 3, New Zealand no success, and only one finals appearance where they were beaten by the Aussies in 88. Australians starting with Jason Stevens in the 13 for the second half. Andrew Johns over the 30-metre line. He was man of the match in that 95 World Cup final when he burst onto the international scene. There he is again. Play the ball from Fletcher. He's got his left knee strapped. Richie Barnett will have some early work to do from his 20-metre line. And the chase of Johns right there. John's playing like a man who knows he's got a bit of time off after this. Nursing a groin injury into this match. Vainikolo gets an early scoring punch, if you like, in this second half. A nice run for 15 metres. Swain, and then for Pongia. Now inside the Australian half. Straight away after Vainikolo did his run. The trainer was straight with him. Henry Paul passes wide for Carroll. It hasn't had the same number of touches, but the battle between Carroll and MacDougall has been a good one. On the opposite side of the park to Vainikolo and Saylor. High ball here for Lockyer. He gets there, Lockyer. Wonderful skills again from the number one.
Yeah, no fear in this take. Eyes on the ball. Nothing else mattered than securing possession for his team. He does it so many times and makes it look so easy. It's not. It's difficult.
2 tries last week, Darren Lockyer, and that too, like Brett Kimorley. First try of the tournament, broke his duck in that semi-final. Australians just short of the 40, so Britt's out there as well to start this second half, and there's his front row partner Stevens. Anderson happy with the work that he's got from his 16 and 17. Yet to see Trent Barrett in the match. Lock his kick. Barnett it is, 8 away from his own line. Saylor there. Nowhere to go for Richie Barnett, New Zealand captain. Vainikolo gets another gallop. Almost back to the 20. And now Vagana. Confronted by Hindmarsh, but was able to keep it alive for Swain. Chris Anderson, pensive. As indeed he was about this stage of the match last week against the Welsh. Talau it is, Bulldog centre. Five short of halfway. Swain, and then with Smith. Back for Jones. They go across field. Easy pickings for the Australian defence. Frank Endacott watches intently. This kick down to the wing of Saylor. That was exclusively where they kicked early in the first half. Sooner or later, you think Wendell will hurt them. Gidley, the try scorer.
That's a good read by Kearney. He knows Gidley likes to get out of dummy half to his right. Picked him off straight away. Good tackle for his team.
And the New Zealand side trying to put a bit of pressure on this Australian attack coming out of their own 30. They're doing that up to this point. Brits with it to the 40. But they're getting through this set of six. As Hindmarsh goes to the left and gets it to halfway. In fact, 2 or 3 metres beyond that mark. This is the fifth tackle. And back for Kamali. Some nice evasive skills to get away from the man coming through. Vangadar's in trouble. Barnett's called into the action. Back near his own goal line. And MacDougall is there in defence. So again, the Kiwis start from their own goal line. Vangada taken back inside by Rogers. It will be a line dropout. Big play from Matthew Rogers. And he knows it.
He got a bit of help too from Andrew Johns, who realised the opportunity from a long way back and came streaming out of the line. I know that Rogers eventually got him back in goal. Here's the kick that bounced wrongly for the New Zealand side. From dummy half, Vagana has to run the ball, and Andrew Johns, you'll see there, has run from 30 metres away to provide a bit of impetus into that tackle that Rogers was able to finish off and pull him in goal. Big play for the Australians.
Well, mark it down. Possible turning point in the whole context of this competition. Rogers tackle on Vagana. Australia full set of six inside the New Zealand half. 35 away, Andrew Johns. Get it with Stevens. It'd be a nice touch if he could find his way for a try today. No tries for the Sharks this year, Jason Stevens. Yet to get off the mark in this tournament. Kamali, Lockyer looking alive to the left. MacDougall, he's away from two. And MacDougall keeps it alive. Here come the Kangaroos with Fletcher running over the top of Kearney, who hangs on. They're five away from the line. They lead by 6 points to nil. Slow to clear was Kearney. Johns goes to the right. Kamali inside ball for Hill. Then it goes for Darren Britt. He's only three away. Another man who would be an unlikely try scorer. Fifth tackle. Andrew Johns. And then Fittler. Here's trouble.
Justifying the faith of Chris Anderson to bring him into the 17 for this match. But again, we go back to, yes, it was a turning point. The tackle on Nigel Vagana after the kick. This gave Australia possession. And they've been able to, in the next set of six, make New Zealand pay. Beautiful ball from Fittler. Nice dummy run from Brett Kamali. And Nathan Hindmarsh doing what he does so well, running onto the football at speed with great power.
Yeah, a little bit of the sucker punch from Australia. As I said before the game and again at half-time, all week of training, they focused their attack down the left-hand side of the field. In the first half, they went predominantly right. Their first opportunity in the second half, they came to the post, went left, created a chance, went to the post again, came left, and on tackle five, Fittler gets Hindmarsh away.
Rogers, 20 out. Again, the flashbulbs go off, and again, Rogers is successful. 12-0 will break from Old Trafford. Welcome you back to Manchester. And from the kickoff, the Kiwis back in possession. Looking to strike straight back after the Hindmarsh try. 12 points to nil. Jones, an error. Carroll comes up with it. Cummings rules somehow. That went backwards. The body language of Rogers told it all as he ran back after kicking that goal. Little clenched fist. He knew how important it was. He's kicked two from two. Neither of them sitters. The first one from the sideline. Smith now. He's 15 away. Swain at dummy half. Henry Paul. Certainly if Australia do score next, it is game over. Here's the kick. He can do no wrong at the moment. Matt Rogers, no fear. Stood his ground with Vagana sprinting through.
The referee ruling here that Rogers left the field of play before being tackled. Therefore, he's going to give a line dropout. A very close call. Rogers leaving the field of play. The line's a little bit deceiving here at Old Trafford, mixing up with soccer lines on the field. It's quite obvious that the referee got it right. Good opportunity for New Zealand. But it's just the class players of Australia, Peter Sterling. Rogers, when he kicks for goal from the sideline, gets his goal, takes his catch. Fittler, when the opportunity presents itself, can put the pass on. Saylor gets some decisions over Vainikolo. It's just little things like that that are determining the game for the Aussies.
And I wouldn't be at all surprised, Phil, if New Zealand don't score shortly, that we see a field goal from the Australian team, just to give them that little bit of more of a comfort zone. 13-0, the opposition needing to score three times. But New Zealand, a chance here. Craig Smith. Tremendous work there. That's a great run.
15 away. They prepare to bring Robbie Paul into the action. He scored five tries in this tournament for New Zealand. Stacey Jones is with it. He's 20 metres away. Now it's with Tony Carroll. The Kiwis for the corner. And great defence, MacDougall. That battle continues on that side. Vagana came close. Now the loose ball. It's play on with New Zealand. They are only 3 metres from the line. The testing time on the Kangaroos now, the World Cup champions. Henry Paul runs to the line, then for Swain. Straightens up and taken by his Melbourne teammate Hill. Stacey Jones left kicking, not high, but there's plenty of time for the Kiwis to get through. Ruben doesn't come down with it. Now Vainikolo's with it. New Zealand's on the board. The video referee will be called again. Vainikolo claims a try, which would be sweet reward for the New Zealand number five. But this bloke, Jerry Kershaw, video referee, we wouldn't know him from a bar of soap, but he's the most important man here right now.
Well, there's no doubt that this is a try. It's gone backwards off the shoulder of Matt Rua. Lesley Vainikolo swoops in. And there's no way known for mine that that has gone forward. I think that this will be four, possibly six. And don't we really have a ball game? And ironic, of course, that it comes from a line dropout restart. Let's have a look here.
Yeah, this ball's gone forward off Lockyer's elbow. I don't know that Matt Rua ever really comes in contact with the ball. It's on his arm, but the ball is going to be knocked free from that, from the elbow of Lockyer. This is more a knock-on against Australia than an infringement by the New Zealand team. Vainikolo on the spot, picks it up and roars his way into the end goal. The Australians trying to put some pressure on the video referee by coming out to the quarter. Looking for a scrum. Lesley Vainikolo will put the ball down. I think we're going to get a green light here, mate.
Well, after the first no try, I'm not game enough to say with any certainty, but after looking at all of those replays, I don't think Rua is knocked on. I think, as you point out, it's come off Lockyer. I don't think it goes forward off Rua.
That first decision perhaps playing on Mr. Kershaw's mind. Having plenty of looks at this. If Vainikolo is awarded the try, he becomes on his own at the top, the leading try scorer in the World Cup. It'll take his tally to nine.
I think he's just making great theatre. He's taking his time. He's building the atmosphere.
It's the theatre of dreams, Gus. That's where we are.
Waiting. That might be ironic. A try sign over the Australian coach. Here it comes.
Try is the decision. They go up as one just about. The crowd here. Vainikolo rewarded with that four-pointer. It's 12-4. It's game on again.
And an extremely important conversion kick coming up here from Henry Paul. You would consider this to be in pretty easy position for him, but so much pressure. Stacey Jones, a lovely little kick. Wasn't a lot of space in there, but the chase was good. A collision of players, and Lesley Vainikolo kisses the ball.
Big kick to Henry Paul. Certainly is a big kick. From 15 out for 12-6. Henry Paul, no stranger to the big match atmosphere. We'll break again from Old Trafford. It's 12-6. The Kangaroos in front. As we welcome you back, 20 past four, Saturday afternoon, local time. Second tackle here after the restart for the Kiwis. Matt Rua, who played his part in the lead up to the try. For Vainikolo, now Barnett. Straight away, the springers in the step of the Kiwis at 12-6.
I was just about to say, they've had no rhythm to their game all day. Suddenly a try, they're getting out of dummy half, they're forcing the Australians back. They're talking, clapping their hands. They really feel like they're in the football game now.
Talau testing the width. And Gidley missed first up. Quick play the ball from Talau. Gives them time to get a roll on with a kick. Henry Paul, pressure again. It comes down off the shoulder of Paul. It's play on for the Australians and almost a chance for little Kamali. Five short of halfway. Odd kick, wasn't it? Held up in the breeze. It looked like it was going to go down the throat of Lockyer. Finished 10 metres short of the number one. Lockyer works here with MacDougall. Yeah, some sort of medical story to tell. He looked gone. Well, bringing out the white blanket after about 5 or 10 minutes for Adam MacDougall. He's out there now and he's moving freely. 40 metres away from the New Zealand line. Jason Stevens. Drop low into Swain, who hangs on in the tackle, topping the count again for New Zealand today. Kamali, 25 away. Kamali is through. Smith has missed him. Kamali inside Lockyer. Magical play from the Kangaroos. Great play, Kamali. Lockyer scores it. But the try belongs to the little number seven from Melbourne, who'll be with the Northern Eagles in 2001.
Our championship qualities there from champion players. Chris Anderson, a little nod of the head there. I go back to the kick at the end of the first set of six from New Zealand. It wasn't a good one. Brett Kamali, coincidentally, was a man who came up with the football. And on this occasion, it's just a quick man against a big, slower man. Kamali on the outside of Craig Smith. Nothing Craig Smith could do there.
Yeah, well, he was let down by his centre, Talau. Talau went up in front of the football, left Kamali on his bigger teammate. It just became a foot race. As you say, class players at important times. Kamali and Lockyer create the opportunity down the short side, finish it off. And Rogers will have a kick from alongside the post to put it out to 12 and take a little of the breeze out of the sails that was building in the Kiwi boat.
You'll correct me if I'm wrong, but Kamali, Clive Churchill medal winner 99 to Lockyer, Clive Churchill medal winner 2000. So they can produce in the biggest matches of the year.
And there's never any need to correct you, Andrew.
Just thought I'd run it past the guru, Pete. Matt Rogers has got two from two. 15 out, 10 to the side of the uprights. Rogers is on target yet again. Hammers it home to the Kiwis. 18-6, we break from Manchester. Kickoff from New Zealand on the restart has forced the error from the Australians, and New Zealand will have a scrum feed 30 metres out. This is a chance we all go to Chris Bombalis on the sideline. Chris?
Yes, New Zealand coach Frank Endacott has told his troops not to throw in the towel. He said the Aussies enjoyed a lot of ball in the first half. They should have had a bigger break than they had at 6-0. Of course, we've had three tries since the break. And Chris Anderson, he wanted no risk footy, and he wanted to watch the fringes of the ruck. That's what he wants the Kangaroos to do. He said another 40 minutes and they will be world champions once again.
Craig Smith is 30 metres away. Oh, God. Marvellous offload away to Swain. Not quite sure where it came from, the pass. Henry Paul, 25 away. Here is Jones. They're down by 12. Fletcher goes the shoulder charge. Jones bounced away like a pinball. Now they're 15 from the line with Pongia. And Fletcher is there. Well, I guess you could say to amend his error on the previous tackle on Jones. Swain. And then Paul. Barnett steps off the right and away again from another. He's beaten three, Richie Barnett. Staying on his feet, he's beaten four. And then pushed back. Exciting for a passage. 9 metres away, last tackle. Henry Paul for Stacey Jones. The Kiwis looking to reply. Oh, Kearney has lost it. It's play on for the Australians. Kamali's away and collected from behind. Now he's lost the ball. Vainikolo comes up with it. 40 metres away from the line. He returns serve to the 30-metre line.
And to the right-hand side, the New Zealand team are calling for the football. They wanted quick hands. They've got it to a degree.
Swann, then back for Paul. Good play. Now Carroll trying to stand up. MacDougall, he's done that. Vagana, they're away again. They're away again. It's time.
Carroll scores. For New Zealand, this game is alive. Who thought it was dead? It's 18-10.
It's a beauty. And what a passage of play. Stephen Kearney, down around his bootlaces from a kick, just came up with a mistake. Kamali picked it up, went the other end, got tackled from behind. The ball came loose. A quick play of the ball, some good work from the inside players. Tremendous work there from Carroll. He actually beat MacDougall twice. Little punch in the air, and they're back in it again. Counter punch.
Yeah, Peter Sterling was saying they were getting to the outside to a degree. That ball there from Logan Swann was the money ball. It created, kept the second phase going, and this man one-on-one is impossible to stop. When he gets that rampage up, he was able to shrug off MacDougall twice, head towards the try line. A little clench of the fists, and his teammates rose to congratulate him. And again, the New Zealanders pick up the chase and come after the Australians.
Now, the Gidley try was converted from a similar position. Paul to put his team six behind.
There it is from Henry Paul. This one is there as well. It's perfect kicking from Rogers and Paul. Stay tuned on the Wide World of Sports. We will break at 18-12. Second half of it has been 6-0 at half time. Now 18-12, and we're not into the final quarter as yet. The New Zealand chant has gone up. You'd reckon we were at the old Carlaw Park. Henry Paul.
And Frank Endacott now playing a couple of aces. He has kept Robbie Paul and Nathan Cayless on the bench. He's now put them into the team for the last quarter of this game. Fresh players with plenty of ability.
And Rule playing it short of halfway. Henry Paul will kick from five inside his own half. He stopped the moment that he kicked it. It's gone straight to Wendell Saylor. It's an unusual reaction from Henry Paul after he struck it. And Saylor gets back and over the 30-metre line. Gidley. Kearney's around his legs. Wonderful effort from Stephen Kearney in this game. Darren Britt now. And they come swarming in over the top. Joe Vagana. He'll be getting used to these conditions. He'll be here next year with Bradford. Australians are five short of halfway. They're up by six. Twice their margin has been 12. And twice now the Kiwis have pegged them back.
Oh, he dropped that ball in playing it. It was missed. No, the touch judge has given a call to referee Cummings.
And it's a good one.
Yeah, he had one in the first half too, Brian Fletcher. He is susceptible to that type of thing. Always has the ball available. Likes to do things quickly. And in the slippery conditions, he's come up with an error to his team.
And now Stacey Jones is away. He's 40 metres from the line. Vainikolo runs at Saylor. He'll get across in cover. 20 metres away. This battle between Saylor and Vainikolo continues. Swann there. Kearney. Now the pressure is on the World Cup champions. New Zealand are serving it up. They're giving it their best shot. Robbie Paul at dummy half. Henry Paul, his brother. He's the older of the two, Henry. And it settles for just a moment. 15 out. Talau found himself on the right side.
Yeah, and Brad Fittler very quick to get across and help MacDougall with Carroll on that occasion. He doesn't want to leave him posted on his own as he did with the previous try.
Robbie Paul. I mentioned in the first half, he scored five tries in this tournament so far. Fifth tackle. This is a big play for the Kiwis here. Stacey Jones, he's five out. Gets the pass for Kearney. Kearney keeps it alive and Saylor. Well, he saved a try, but Wendell, the way he reacted, thought he's cost himself a try. He had visions of running 95 metres.
Well, what he has done has knocked on close to his line, so the pressure is maintained. Frank Endacott. On his toes in the grandstand. The strain showing on the faces of the players.
They're just not quite sure, the Kiwis, how they're going to get the try. They just know they're very close to getting one. Ball going from one side of the field to the other. Physically is probably their option. Good, hard, straight running back on the inside from big men. Kearney, Vainikolo, Carroll.
But they have the guile of the Paul brothers. I think that's their best chance. This man and his brother.
Henry Paul passes for Barnett. Rogers, not a good grip. MacDougall's got him. 10 away, Carroll. Fond memory, that try he scored here at Old Trafford. He'll recollect that in years, 20, 30 years down the track, it was a fine try for his country. First time out for them in this tournament. Offload from Cayless has kept it alive for Paul, then Jones, then Kearney. Will this be the try? Vainikolo, great hands. Five from the line, and then back for Robbie Paul. This is wonderful rugby league from both teams. The attack of New Zealand, the scramble of the Kangaroos. Kearney, Jones, then it comes away for Paul. That's Henry. Henry is tackled and keeps it alive for Swann. And the defence of Fittler was wonderful. Henry Paul has left it behind from dummy half. That's the anti-climax, and what a reaction from Frank Endacott. Head goes down like a beaten favourite. And Rogers is back for the Kangaroos.
Well, importantly, the Kiwi heads didn't go down. They realised it was an error, but quickly formed up in defence. Now they come forward in numbers to smash away at the Australian forwards. They sense that another possession at this end of the field could be the one that does it for them.
18-12. Still stacks of time. 17 minutes remaining here at Old Trafford.
Oh, great stuff. Great stuff from both teams. This is a World Cup final. It is a beauty. As Darren Britt, he gets pummeled as well.
Pummeled the word. Cayless and Roar it was. Johns. Fittler kicks them out of trouble. Now making heavy weather of it. Vainikolo does well. What about Vainikolo's hands on that previous set from New Zealand? He got a terrible ball. He just put a glove down to it and collected it around his ankles.
Well, Wendell Saylor's been forced to come up with a couple of real saves on this right-hand side, not the least of which was rushing in on Kearney to force his pass into error. He's really saved the Australians' bacon on a couple of occasions now.
Kiwi the chant here at Old Trafford. Paul with Joe Vagana running at Gidley. He'd be the heaviest man out there, Joe Vagana, around 120 kilos. Robbie Paul propping. He's almost used Joe Vagana there as a shepherd. Henry Paul, Stacey Jones. Not almost, he did. Oh, Carroll's put it down. A couple of costly errors from New Zealand. Last two visits to that danger zone. Carroll knows it.
Yeah, put down by Carroll. Brad Fittler tried to pick this up on the run. I don't know that he'd be that unhappy that he knocked it on, in fact. Been a frantic period of play and just a little bit of a breather to set up a scrum. I think Andrew Johns has gone down injured near the scrum to try and buy some time for the Australians. Had Fittler fallen on the ball, they'd have had to play away straight away. And they are just running on a little bit of fatigue at the moment.
And Trent Barrett has come into the game for the Australians as Gordon Tallis at 5'8 from this scrum win, taken by Henry Paul. And it does look as though Adam MacDougall is the man that has been taken from the field.
Let's take a comment from the sideline, Chris Bombalis.
See, the atmosphere is fantastic here on the sideline. You can really feel the pressure. One man under a lot of pressure is Adam MacDougall. He's come off. He's finally succumbed to that ankle injury. But the team, the medicos, are saying keep moving, keep warm, just in case he needs to come back out.
Yeah, I think with that change, Barrett going to centre, and here he goes.
Straight away, Barrett. 30 away.
I'd be swapping him in defence with Brad Fittler. Put Brad Fittler on Tony Carroll. Let Barrett defend at 5'8", his normal position. And then when they get the ball, change the attack, because as Barrett showed, he can split them out wide with his great pace.
This is the fifth tackle. Kamali passes across, and Hill's ball fired out for Gidley. Flick pass back for Saylor. Hard to stop from there. Wendell's over. Wendell is over for the Kangaroos. They open the margin up again. Wendell, he was denied a try in the first half. There'll be no denying him this time. And again, he's levelled with Lesley Vainikolo in the try-scoring stakes at this World Cup.
Yeah, the hardest man in the world to take one-on-one. But I've got to say, New Zealand were absolutely awful in defence here. They had enough troops to cover three men. It was just very, very poor play. Look at them race across. Three men actually ended up going for Matthew Gidley. But all they needed to do was to say, look, stay on the outside. We'll cover Saylor if he comes back on the inside. That's really poor play at this level.
Yeah, Willie Talau used to up and in defence with the Canterbury club. Left his men posted again. And for mine, that's the third try in 5 minutes for Wendell Saylor. You don't have to score tries to have an impact on the game. You can save them as well. And at the other end of the field, Wendell Saylor has twice come off his wing and forced the New Zealanders into error, saved his team tries. And then when he gets an opportunity 100 yards away at the other end of the field, his great finishing prowess has given the Australians breathing space again.
That's now 12 tries in his last six tests. Wendell Saylor, Rogers, kick from five in from touch. 20 out. Scored 24 points in the Anzac Test. Rogers. It's coming back from Matt Rogers. Four from four. He draws the bow back. 24-12, the World Cup final. And Matt Rogers, Wendell Saylor's getting a few headlines in these matches, but in this match, but Rogers has certainly played his part as well.
There you can see the number four. He was never going to do anything else but drive Matthew Gidley towards the sideline. He should have stopped, showing faith in his outside man to handle Gidley. He could have got Saylor quite comfortably. This ball is out on the full.
Oh.
And the way Matt Rogers is kicking today, I would say he'll expect a phone call from Alex Ferguson.
Well, it comes down to class players again, doesn't it? I mean, Wendell Saylor, Gidley executed their play perfectly. Rogers, every time he's been called upon for a crunch goal, he's kicked it. Two from the sideline now. That's expected big players in big games. Australians haven't put their best foot forward for the entirety of this tournament. They've saved their best for the big day.
Here it goes, 12 and a half remaining. New Zealand, if they are to edge back, they must hang on in this set of six. Webke, he's 15 out and make that 10.
Well, they might smell blood here, Australia, but I'd still opt just for the 1 point. I think 13 points, it would break the opposition. Psychologically, too much to overcome.
Some pretty good front-on work from Robbie Paul on Fittler. Stopped him in his tracks, but such as the skills of Brad Fittler, he was able to offload. Now with Hill. Swann wasn't totally committed to the tackle. Kamali's there. Rua's got him. They're 12 metres out. No suggestion of a field goal just yet. Fittler is lurking. As they keep it alive, they come wide. Rogers, they can put the Kiwis to bed here. And back with Fittler. Now Britt, 10 out. Good offload. Running his hindmarch. He's already got one try in this World Cup final. This is the last tackle. They're in position for the field goal. Kamali back. They go to the right with Lockyer. One step off the right foot. Keeps it alive. Oh. Saylor's going to score again for the Kangaroos. That'll be it. Saylor gets his second. And they are bounding around like Kangaroos right now. The green and gold machine is on its way to another World Cup victory. Make it their ninth.
They have saved their best to last. Brett Kamali was frantic for the football on the other side. He was going to take the 1 point. But no, it was never on. Darren Lockyer, he looked like he was going to slide through himself. When he came to grief, the football straight over his head. Not willy-nilly, straight onto the chest of Matt Gidley, and then a simple task to put an unmarked Saylor over. Great hands from Gidley as well.
Yeah, we'll use it again. Great vision by Johns from dummy half. Found Lockyer. But this is class with a capital C-L-A-S-S. Tremendous vision by Johns. Lockyer knows he's in trouble. Over the top, Gidley, catch. Comfortable. Even though he's juggling the ball, there's no panic. Saylor stays near him, knows that it'll come. The Australians celebrate.
Matt Rogers, four from four. He's loving it here at Old Trafford. That one just to the side of the posts. But they're in a comfort zone now. The lead is 16 points, World Cup final. Chris Bombalis, sideline.
I don't know if Wendell Saylor has ESP, but the team was talking to the Prime Minister a couple of days ago, and Wendell told the Prime Minister that he was the leading try scorer for the tournament. He was, in fact, level with Lesley Vainikolo. Two today makes him the leading try scorer in the tournament. So maybe he was predicting he was going to score a double today.
Kiwis trying that short kickoff again. Crowd not quite silent, but now we're starting to hear the strains of, well, I don't know what they're singing, Land Down Under, all sorts of things. Waltzing Matilda. It started here at Old Trafford. The Australian contingent, their team is up by 16.
It's hard to isolate individuals in great team performances, but you've got to give a lot of credit to Andrew Johns. This player has been troubled all week, hasn't trained for a couple of weeks with the Australians. He plays out of position in the national team at hooker. His defence has been outstanding. Dummy half play, excellent. Here he comes again, screaming. Oh!
Wendell had three in mind.
Tremendous performance by Andrew John. Watch him take the tap. Just creates a little two-on-one for Gidley. Wendell just a little too anxious.
On their way to the final, the Australians defeated England game one at Twickenham, 22-2. Then the expected results over Fiji and Russia. Quarterfinals, a tune-up against Samoa, 66-10. And last week, the semi-final win over Wales, 46-22. They've stepped up a grade here. They've handled it like the champion team they are. Here's Wiki. He's 25 away from his own line. Kiwi fans trying to ignite something via the Mexican wave. Richie Barnett, he's on his 30-metre line. But the zest is gone from the attack. Jones, cut-out ball, Vainikolo. Sailor there. It's still been a highlight. Sailor against Vainikolo. Cayless carries inside Kangaroos territory. Fifth tackle. Robbie Paul tries the short kick. Lockyer will have it covered. Gets a good bounce. Lockyer's away for the Australians and almost back to halfway. Robbie Paul just trying some of his skills. That's the Mexican wave. Talau. 45 from the line. You think about, well, you isolate the Broncos players alone and think of their year all the way through the domestic competition for many of them, or certainly for all the ones on show here, State of Origin, full finals campaign, and now World Cup. It's been a massive year. Nathan Hindmarsh, and then you think of players like Brad Fittler, who had the success of the Origin series, record-breaking series, grand final with the Roosters, big tackle there from Vagana on Andrew Johns. And Fittler now captain of this Australian side in his third World Cup. John's catching his breath after that Vagana tackle. Lockyer, pass comes out, and here is that man on cue, Brad Fittler. Salute the captain, salute the skipper, the best in the world, Brad Fittler, puts the icing on the cake. It is so sweet for Bradley Fittler.
Well, he scored a try in extra time in the semi-final in 95. Very reminiscent of that. We've seen it a couple of times through this tournament. It was there against Wales last weekend, against a tiring defence. The big left-foot sidestep, too much to contain, too much to handle, and fitting that the captain may well get the last of this World Cup and the last of our rugby league season.
So versatile, the Australian team. Lockyer filling in at 5'8 there to push Fittler a little wide. And Fittler's ability to catch and straighten in the one motion. Catch the high ball, land on his left foot, straighten the attack, then left foot step on the fullback to go around and score. He'll really enjoy that one. Bradley Fittler been so good for so long. But that will be very, very special to him, a try in the World Cup final.
Matt Rogers converts. Brad Fittler, the only survivor from the 92 World Cup success. One of only two that were there in 95. He was there with Andrew Johns. And here is the captain at 28 years of age.
Yeah, well, the moustaches are a shocker. That's about the only mar on his tour, I've got to say. But I guess the quality of that run there is shown by the last defender was Richie Barnett. And you know that Richie Barnett, he knew exactly what was coming. He knew that in that situation, a big left foot step was in the offing, and he still couldn't handle it.
That's what makes the great players great. Most people know over a period of time what they're capable of, what they can do, but they do it anyway and get away with it.
And if all matches on this tour are recognised as test matches in the record books, I'll get back to that point. Fittler is joining some illustrious company. They're away again with Barrett. Oh, they're going to be a try-scoring feast to finish. Young Trent Barrett, talk about moments in a young bloke's career. He's got one at Old Trafford as well. Trent Barrett scores. Hindmarsh got one earlier in the first half. And look at the players, his teammates rush to the St. George Illawarra 5-8.
Well, Fittler didn't get the last of the season. Maybe the heir apparent did. You think that this man is going to have the number six on his back in the green and gold jersey in years to come. When Brad Fittler decides to call it quits, there is a ready-made replacement. Beautiful work here. Again, against a tiring, dispirited defence, through the dummy on the outside to Rogers. Barnett committed himself, and Trent Barrett. Well, he's a player of the future, if he hasn't already arrived.
Yeah, it's somewhat poetic. Brad Fittler, the experienced man, onto what you say is the heir apparent, what we all believe will be. Brad Fittler's been very encouraging of Trent Barrett right from the time he was a junior. Trent Barrett loves to play with Brad Fittler, admires him, respects him, and picks up the dregs there to race away for what will be a memorable try here at Old Trafford.
Rogers is able to convert from in front. I will complete my point about Fittler because it is quite a significant one. With his four tries scored at this tournament, he now moves up to equal fourth all-time on the Australian Test try-scoring list, behind only Irvine, Gasnier and Meninga. I mean, that is all-star.
And as Matt Rogers adds the extras, I guess the only disappointing thing about this final is going to be the scoreline, to the extent that people who didn't watch the game will pick up the paper tomorrow. They'll see 40-12 and say, well, it was a cakewalk. And we know that that has not been the case. I guess the unfortunate thing in sport is that the champions, when they get on top, they don't, there's no relenting. They put the pedal down as much as they can, and they inflict as much of a defeat as they can on the opposition. They did it against Wales, they'll do it again, but the scoreline does not reflect the quality of this contest.
I think it's 4 tries in 12 minutes, Peter, to the Kangaroos. But they're playing like the best in the world. They're about to be crowned that again.
It's always difficult in big games when you've had a big build-up, an emotional build-up. There's been a long period of physical play. You lose touch with the game and suddenly your emotion doesn't carry you. And that's what's happened with the Kiwis here. The Australians playing with the confidence of the big lead are really showing their skills and their wares. Kiwis can't compete now.
Hill back for Gidley. Andrew Johns. Now it's time for a bit of song and dance as Rogers keeps it alive for Barrett. Yeah, just 10, 12 minutes ago we were contemplating the possibility of extra time. That has been blown out of the water. And some of these young Australians reveling in the occasion. It's been maligned in some quarters, the World Cup tournament. There's been some disappointing attendances, some lopsided score lines, but this occasion is up there with any sport to arrive here today.
And again, Andrew, it will be maligned because of the scoreline, unfortunately, but International Rugby League, as we've seen in the last month, it is so important. Made the mention at halftime, just the likes of seeing Roger Millwood and Vince Karelius and the like. Andy Gregory is here. The great players that Australian crowds have watched on television, gracing the fields of Wembley and the like. Now, we've got to keep that going as that kick goes out on the full. And this is the way to do it.
This is a very positive sign for English Rugby League. I mean, we must have over 40,000 people here today for a game between Australia and New Zealand in Manchester. Now, God knows what the crowd would have been had England got through to the final. But they're certainly building up their development of Rugby League here in England. They're looking to strike back against Rugby Union. They'll probably never outrate soccer, or definitely never outrate soccer, but we need the international competition. Australia, England and New Zealand have got to provide the development for the rest of the world in this code. And this is a great start for it.
Talau short of halfway. He saved his best match for last at this World Cup. Perhaps a little quiet in the second half, but his first 40 minutes was everything we expect from Gordon. There's Johns, they turn to the right. Kamali's had a fine game as well. Gidley, great skills. Dropped it onto the left foot. Getting across his Barnett, it goes over the sideline. But we look forward to many years of Gidley and Saylor combining down that right side. They've done it many times in the tournament. The countdown's on here. There will be no time for the scrum to pack. That is it. They are world champions yet again. And the scoreline says that they have done it in grand style. 40 points to 12. But as Sterlow said, all those here will know, it has been quite a battle. Their ninth World Cup victory. And the last six have been in succession. Triumphant pitches here at Old Trafford for the Kangaroos, and Brad Fittler right in the centre of it. Three straight World Cup final victories. He scores a try this afternoon. It's his second as captain,